like less than an hour and our bellies are full and our bladders are empty. So we are ready to get somewhere and disconnect without yelling at each other. Let's go.
All right, Salty.
We're in the middle of an insane windstorm right now.
When you're driving, there's just like chargers and more chargers and more chargers.
Every year, they come out with more technology to make it more confusing. It's like you're gearing up for a space shuttle mission. Like,
watch that, Captain. 3, 2, 1.
All I'm saying is, like, we're right there with you.
We are just a bunch of goofballs that decided to sell our home, live full-time in an RV, and we want to show you guys that if we could do it, you can do it too. The Cracker Barrel.
The Cracker Barrel.
Oh, we heard it. Got you. Hopefully we fit, because somebody said in the reviews that they didn't really fit. Our door won't shut with these steps on the grass. It's kind of a okay situation for them too, because I'm sure they don't want these steps on the grass. You're hungry, I could tell.
Yeah, I'm starving. I've been eating all day.
Carl is hungry. Notice there's no talk of hashtags when he's hungry or anything.
Looks like on the inside.
Yeah. Are you guys warm enough? Do you want your robe?
Are you warm enough, buddy? He's good.
What about you? You're wearing a t-shirt, but you want to run the furnace.
Well, let's just turn the furnace off now. I'm toasty.
Don't give me that sauce.
Good morning, and welcome to another episode of Dumping Tanks with the Hanks. And if it's your first time joining our channel, I'm Nene, that's Carl, also known as Renee and Kyle. If you're not sure what you're watching or what this is about, we are just a bunch of goofballs that decided to sell our home, live full-time in an RV, travel the country, and we want to show you guys that if we could do it, you can do it too. Right here is something that I like to call a hidden gem when you're out in the road. This is considered a county or city park, and there are a lot of these across the country. We find places like this through our All States Pro program. These are nice. They're always in such like a really quiet, clean part of town. Never had any issues. It's a first come, first serve, and you can stay for maybe like 3 to 5 nights. They usually have water, electric, a dump station on site. We want to show you guys something that we got, and we're going to set it up, and you guys are going to be so excited, and you're going to be like,
it's about time.
What do you got there?
TPMS!
Oh my gosh.
You know, this is important to have.
And why is it important to have? Thank you guys for asking. Very good question. It's because all of you guys in the comments have been saying, well, you can't just be driving around everywhere on the road and expecting your tire pressures are always going to remain constant. And this is where this bad boy comes in clutch.
Thank you to Alberto and Tammy from Utah. They sent this as a gift.
Are amazing.
Yeah.
I don't know if he sent this as a gift or you guys just felt sorry for us.
Yeah, maybe.
You guys are just like,
he was like, I can't take it anymore. They need one of these.
We are not giving you guys a shout out here to say, hey, everyone else, you need to be buying us stuff.
No.
We just want to bring light that there are amazing people out there that do such great things out of the kindness of their heart. And so shout out to you guys. We love you. We love everyone out there. Listen, this world is
not as scary as everyone else makes it out to be.
There are awesome people in this world. So here's to you, Alberto and Tammy. We're going to go throw these bad boys on right now.
Oh, that looks awesome.
You put it like that.
I mean, you look like you're on a woman on a mission here. So
I'll just set it up. Do you guys feel like it's the never-ending struggle of wires? When you're driving, there's just like chargers and more chargers and more chargers. Look, this is like NASA.
That's what I'm saying.
That's what I'm saying.
All right.
We got you. We hear you loud and clear. Every year, they come out with more technology to make it more confusing. It's like you're gearing up for a space shuttle mission. Like,
roger that, Captain. 3, 2, 1.
All I'm saying is, like, we're right there with you.
That's where you're gonna put it.
I think it's great right there. What do you think?
Is this kind of the way your guys' relationship goes? Like, just one of you just kind of makes a decision and is like, yeah, we're going with it. And the other is like, I guess we're going with it.
I don't need that thing to be in my face. Off to the side's good. You got the phone right here.
Like, you're doing all the driving anyways.
Honey, I am.
Yeah, I guess you are.
These tires, the all-terrain BF Goodrich, they are holding up amazingly well. Fantastic tires. And we learned something new. You're not gonna believe this. We were watching Jurassic Park. Lo and behold, you know, the cool little Jurassic Park cars that they pull up in the first one, and they're all like,
taking you to the Tyrannosaurus Rex.
They actually are running BF Goodrich all-terrains on there as well. Currently on I-80 right now. Just want to stop and say hey to you guys, because I'm saying hey to you guys in the comments right now. You guys are incredible and saying so many amazing things to us. We just can't thank you guys enough for all your support, your love, your encouragement, us going through this whole incident recently with the tree and having the RV back. I'm talking to my favorite peoples, and that is you guys.
We're in the middle of an insane windstorm right now. It's literally like 3 o'clock in the morning. 2:49 to be exact. We are literally dry camping or boondocking in a Tractor Supply parking lot. The whole RV is just rocking all night long constantly. It's calling for like 30 to 40 mile an hour wind gusts right now. I'm really hoping this one stops soon, because every time I'm just about to fall asleep, it feels like the camper is gonna blow over. No place like home, right? Everyone's saying click your heels 3 times. No place like home. More home.
I'm gonna go in the truck to talk to you. Good morning. I mean, it's not really that cold, but the wind is brutal. Whew.
Hope my hair's okay, Marie, guys.
Way to go, Carl. I wanted to share with you guys, because this transporter named Michael, ever since he mentioned it, I added it to my most used apps while on the road. It's called Windy. It basically will give you indication of where there's high winds and where there's like wind gusts happening. Not a long drive day. Yesterday we went like 650 miles, which is way more than we ever planned to go. But today we're just going like 300 miles at the most.
It is windy out there.
I was telling them about the app, Windy.
Oh, snap. Well, that
actually is so fitting.
You ready to hit the road?
Let's do this. I am so ready.
I'll take a high five.
Okay, cool. I love that.
Yes.
Been here before, and this is like one of my favorite places on I-80. Can you hear me in there okay? It's only windy on top of the RV.
My hair's all crazy, but that's just for you guys, just so you get the full effect of how breezy it is out here.
We're so glad you guys are here. We love you guys.
We were at this rest stop 4.5 years ago when we were on our way to our first travel assignment. We had our 27-foot Grand Design Imagine travel trailer. And we were like, oh my God, this is so cool.
It
and guess
awesome.
What? 4.5 years later, we're still saying, wow, this is so,
so cool. This is awesome. I love it out here. And we have come full circle, literally full circle.
We've done a couple circles.
Couple circles.
Yeah.
We're circling back and we're here again.
Write this one down if you guys are driving across country and you're gonna be on Interstate 80. East or west, because it doesn't matter. I think you can get to it from either side.
It's so awesome. The red rock walls are right behind us. We're sitting up here enjoying the views and grabbing some lunch. We packed some Sammies. We're getting ready to hit the road again. Get out here. We believe in you. We're rooting for you.
I also have a trick for you. If maybe you're
in our situation where you need
to get the slide out to access your fridge and like make lunch and stuff, park in the very first site or the very last site. So what we like to do is go all the way to the end, which is risky because there might not be a spot and then you're kind of like stuck.
You gotta risk it to get the biscuit.
Yes.
Was that a Thanks Hanks tip, by the way?
That was a Thanks Hanks tip. You know what's great though?
What?
Is that we only have like 20 minutes to drive after this. Like less than an hour and our bellies are full and our bladders are empty. So we are ready to get somewhere and disconnect without yelling at each other. Let's go.
All right, Salty.
Give me my food. Listen, Carl, I'm getting out of here.
All right, later. I'll just sit up here. Don't fall. I'm sitting up here for the drive.
No, you're gonna come down. It's time to go.
Fine. I don't wanna go. We finally pulled over just for a second, just to grab some lunch. It's pretty incredible to be home. I mean, it's just weird to hit such a long journey, all the states you see, and then you kind of come home and it's just like, wow, what a beautiful area this is. I mean, it's just amazing out here. The fresh air, the trees, just a whole new appreciation. Once you get out here on the road and you start seeing things, you realize sometimes you take things for granted, and that's totally normal as a human. It's just in our nature to take things for granted and just not sit back and appreciate. So it's great being home. If you didn't know, Lassen Park is actually part of the Ring of Fire. Mount Shasta, Mount Lassen, it actually exploded back in the 1800s and it blew chunks of volcanic rock like 60 to 100 miles away. It was insane. Pretty cool. A lot of history around this area. And it's just good to be home. Nene just made some lunch.
It's an hour until we reach our destination, so you know what we did. Then we let the truck pass first.
Good day.
Good day, sir. It was an hour before our destination, so you know what we had to do.
What?
Even though we were both like, maybe we should just keep going.
Tell us, because we are just dying to know.
We pulled over to empty our bladders and grab some food.
In case you guys didn't know, it's not like a super trendy thing, but we've just been trying to take it a little bit more healthy with life, and we started doing an intermittent fasting thing, which basically, I know, is we just don't eat for 16 hours straight, and then we eat for like 8 hours. So, you know, it's just kind of nice. It gives us a little more energy. We drink some black coffee to wake us up in the mornings.
Yeah. When we eat, we get sluggish. So we just figure, like, let's keep that energy going all day and then we'll eat later.
And then by 3 o'clock, I'm just ready to.
No, you're not. I'm ready.
Oh, she's getting her steps in for the day, too. Wow, I love that.
Ready?
Wow, that was amazing. Where can I buy your products?
Nene.com.
Let's hit the road. You guys ready?